Are you about to launch a Webflow site, but you're feeling overwhelmed with all the last minute checks that you need to do? In the next couple of minutes, I'm gonna show you my tried and tested process for making sure your Webflow site is completely ready for launch. And in the end, I'll even share my free checklist with you that you can just duplicate completely for free. So make sure you stick around till the end, and let's get started. Hey friends, welcome back to the channel. My name is Rafael. I'm a designer and Webflow developer based in Austria. And on this channel, we are going to explore how we can use tools like Webflow and Framer to become more successful, more productive, and find new clients for our business. Today, I will show you the exact steps that you need to take to launch any Webflow site and connect it to your real domain. So first step, you need to check all the page titles, the title tags, and also the meta description in Webflow. So to do this, we're gonna jump straight into Webflow. We're gonna open up here the Pages tab, and we click the settings icon here, and then we get all the page settings, the specific ones. And here, the top one is the page name, also the title, which is very important. This should be the correct name that you want also users to see. And when we scroll down here, we have the title tag. This is what users will see when they look up your site on Google, when it's shown on Google. And below is the meta description, which will be right below the title. This is the first step. You definitely need to do this. It's a very important part for SEO. Please keep in mind that you need to do this for every site, not just once. As you see here, the meta description here is not filled in yet, so it would need another description. Next point is very important. You need to add a favicon to your site. So how to do that? We go into the site settings over here. It's like the global site settings. And then I already added it. You need to add two kinds of favicons here. One is 32 by 32 pixels. And one is 256 by 256. It's like a web clip image. You can just upload it here. And yeah, not too hard, I think. The next one is just below here of the favicon. It's to remove the Webflow branding. We just scroll down here, here under the tab Webflow branding, and we can disable it from both the made in Webflow badge and the HTML, and we save it. I think for some of them, I'm not sure. I think you already need a paid plan. When you want to launch your website, you will anyway have a paid plan, so that shouldn't be a problem. All right, step number two, add SEO tags or alt tags. And to do this, we go straight back into Webflow and you go to your assets panel and you just open any image here that you uploaded. And here we see that here's the name. This is also one important thing, that your images are named correctly. So it's very important for SEO. So that Google can index your site and know what's on there. And the second one is here, the alt text. This is important for accessibility, but also for, again, SEO. I would maybe put King in chess as a 3D rendering, because it's a 3D rendering. Then I go out of it, it's saved. That's basically it. So make sure that your images are named correctly and that they all have the alt text. And one more tip for this one. And when you go here on publish, you're gonna see that there's 11 issues to improve on this page. If you click on it, it will specifically tell you that there is specific instances where you're missing alt text. And you can go straight to the assets and improve on that. So that's very convenient for you to improve upon. By the way, if you're finding this guide helpful, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe for more content like this. All right, the next one is open graph settings. This is very easy to find when you know where to find it. So we go back to Webflow, we go to this page, open the page settings again, and scroll all the way down to open graph settings. It also says here, this is how it will look on when it's shared on Facebook, Twitter, or other social media. Just say that it's the same as SEO title tag, so you don't need to put anything different unless you want to, but by default it just takes it from here. And then very important here is the open graph image URL. So how do we actually get this URL? This is kind of funny how to get there. I will show you. Let's say, for example, I want to set this king again right here, this three-dimensional one. I open this kind of tab, and then I open here, and it takes me to the image. And then you need to go to your browser and copy the link. Just copy it to my clipboard. Then I go back and I go back to the page settings. Just paste this in here. And it's basically done. That's all you need to do. And if we go back in here, you see that the open graph preview now shows this image. And that's it for the open graph settings. Pretty easy. All right, next one is to hide all the style guide pages and other pages that you don't want anyone to see. So you go back into Webflow. I'm gonna go back into the designer here. Then we go to the pages. And here we see everything that the site has. Let's say, for example, this queen page here is not finished yet, and I don't want people to see it. So how do I do that without deleting it? I go into the settings, and then I go here under the little arrow and save as draft. And once I click here, it will be not seen anymore on the live site. For this to take effect, I need to publish it here. And as soon as I do that, the site will be unpublished and no one will see it anymore. This is great if you have a style guide. You don't want people to see it, so save it as draft. Okay, next one is actually a to-do for your client. If you're working with a client, you should have spellcheck him all the content on the site. This is a little bit sometimes tricky because some clients actually expect you to do that, but it is really the responsibility of your client. For example, if you work with some very technical industry client, there's a lot of things that you don't know how to really write properly. Let's say you work with a chemical manufacturer and you really need the expertise of your client. So it's really his responsibility to check all the content and check all the images and all the wordings of the site. So make sure you let your client know that he should spell check the website and make sure all the images and text is correct. So the last and final one is to set up your analytics. You can do this in a couple of different ways, either through Google Analytics or whatever tool you prefer. I usually use Google Analytics. So how do we actually set up analytics in Webflow? Let's head back to the site settings here. We go into apps and integrations, and here you need to add your Google tag or measurement ID, it's called here. And you get this by setting up a property in Google Analytics. If you want a deeper dive on this topic, I can make a video about that. But for now, let's just say you need to create a Google property, Google Analytics property, and fill it in here. And what you also need to do then is to copy, go here to custom code, and you copy the Google tag in here as a script so that it loads for your site. And don't forget to publish the site after you've done it, so it will take effect. And that's basically it. So that's basically all you need to do to make your site ready for launch. There are still a couple tiny things that you would need to do. And I've made a full Notion checklist that's completely free for you to check out. And I will link down to it in the description if you want to check it out. And I hope it will be valuable to you. Thank you so much for watching. And recently we hit the 100 subs mark. So I'm really happy and grateful for that. And thank you for everyone who recently subscribed. I'm hoping it can bring a lot of value to you, and hope to see you in the next video.